everyone.
Next up, our TV writer, Graham. He's also hoping that CGT will help bring his talent to a worldwide audience.
I'm Graham Chittenden. I'm 38 years old. People always ask how I got into comedy, and I don't have a great answer other than I sort of just quit all the other things I was doing until comedy was what was left. Currently, I work as a TV writer. It's the kind of comedy that works while you're wearing a cardigan.
Is that a charcuterie board?
It has a whole box of them right there.
Oh.
Oh, is that? Oh. Oh, that's... Nope. Okay, now I see. You might be short one board. I'm sorry. I can wash it.
I'm confident that I have a good act, but this is a rare situation where how do you compare what I'm doing to feats of Taekwondo expertise? Yeah! Knowing that I'm on the show, but I'm not the most important part, makes me feel comfortable.
Nice work, everybody. That's good work.
Okay.
Oh.
All right, we're really doing this.
What is your name?
Graham Chittenden.
All right, where are you from?
I know him.
He knows me.
I know you. I know him from the comedy scene.
Yeah. Ah.
I know him. We've worked together.
Yes.
I know you.
You've tortured me.
He may torture you again tonight. So what have you been doing since you rocked the stage with Howie?
Oh, just riding on the high. But,
All right, well, listen, I am super, super ready for you to do your thing, so the stage is yours.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Yes. Oh, it would be... It'd be good to win. It'd be okay. I would like it. It'd be nice. It's not my dream. My dream, truthfully, is to be 65 years old. That's all I've ever wanted. To retire and be 65 years. I don't know if you know this, that's the best age you can be. Every day of your life after the age of 65, you feel the way the rest of us only feel like Friday at work when you get back from lunch. You know that special feeling where there's lots of time left, but you're not gonna start anything big. That's what I'm ready for my whole life to feel like. I want to walk around, see what other people are doing, maybe tidy up a drawer. That's all I want to get out of life. Senior citizens are having more fun than anybody else here. If you don't believe me, next time, go to the Lost and Found at a casino, and you'll see something that'll change your life. Canes. There are canes. Did you know that? There are canes in the Lost and Found of casinos because there are old people there having so much fun, they forget they can't walk sometimes. How much fun are you having? When was the last time you were like, something's different, but I'll just crawl? That's how much fun these people are having. We should know they're having more fun than us. There's clues out there. Like in 30 years, I'm gonna find out what's so great at 4 in the morning that I'm gonna get up for it every day of the week. Right now, if I sleep till noon, that's my favorite day of the week because I almost missed it. That's how your life is for a while. And then you have jobs to go to and kids to raise. And then you turn 65, job's done, kids are who cares where. And you start jumping out of bed 45 minutes before the sun comes up every day for the rest of your life. And your first thought is, I got nothing to do today, and I'm gonna get started. Yeah. Yeah, if I'm gonna accomplish nothing, I'd better get on top of things. That front window's not gonna stare out of itself. And somebody's got to call the cops on people parked illegally on this street. Yeah, and we know it's you, old neighbor. We know. We can figure it out. The curtains swoosh, the cops show up. I can piece it together. I'm not even mad. I'm jealous. I want to be an old guy. You ever been stuck in line behind an old guy at the bank? Of course you have. He got there before you. He had a huge head start. He's been up for 12 hours at this point. He didn't come here to open a checking account or pay any bills. He just came in here to say hello and tell everybody what this building was before it was the bank. That's it. Thank you so much. Come on. You don't have to.
Look at that. That's what I'm talking about.
Listen, Graham, here's the thing. You know why it was so funny to Howie is because you literally did
whole
routine on his life. You know what? I felt comfy. It was hilarious the whole time. You brought it tonight, man.
Thank you.
You did an excellent job, for sure. I'm gonna go to Trish.
Graham, you have such great stage presence, energy. The crowd felt it. You have great likability. I loved it.
Thank you.
Excellent job.
Absolutely. Lily.
Listen, it is really hard to do a comedy set in 2 minutes. And the amount that you covered, was just so impressive. It was so natural. Your cadence was excellent, and your storytelling ability was just phenomenal. I had a really, really great time listening. I thought it was amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. You guys are... Oh, come on.
Sir Howie?
I'm so excited right now. I tell you, we don't really know each other as much as we've worked together. And when I worked with him and I watched him on stage before, I thought, why is this guy not a household name? And that's because he has spent his time behind the scenes writing some of the best Canadian television that you have ever seen. Now you're on a national stage, and I think that you have just made your career go up 10 levels. Can I have the honor of voting first?
Of course.
Yes!
Oh, thank you.
Lily?
It's a really big honor for me to also say yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Trish.
Yes, Graham.
Thank you.
Just to make sure that it is capped off properly, it's a big yes, sir!
Congratulations!
Yes, sir! Oh,
thank you.
We'll see you in
thank
the next
you.
Round.
Wow.
You killed it.
Thank you.
Thank you, buddy.
Yeah, congratulations. Oh,
wow. Thank you.
Love that
guy. That was really special.
That's how you do it.
I'm so excited for you.
Oh, thank you.
I'm so excited for you.
Thank you.